Hello. In today's mini-tutorial, I'd like to start a new section on our site, Pieces of Advice S4. A long time has passed since, for example, the video of making a cardboard bottom was shot. Time is passing, we are getting to know the new nuances, sharing pieces of advice with each other, use them in practice, and I'd like the beginners to be able to make use of these pieces of advice as well. It is what we start this section for. So, the nuances of making a cardboard bottom. Earlier, when I used to just glue the tubes with pieces of cardboard, leave them up and weave, it happened sometimes that there appeared holes at the joints, a kind of defect, because when we feed the form, we cut the bottom strictly corresponding to the form. And when we pull the form, we have to pull the tubes hard, but it doesn't always help to avoid the holes either. But recently, Margalina has shared such a method on the forum. I'm very satisfied with this method, and I'd like to share it with you too. So, it will be one of the nuances of twining the bottom round, and there is another one that has been discussed recently. It is the usage of double-sided sticky tape. I want to show you how to apply these two pieces of advice in practice. So, look, I have made such a workpiece corresponding to the size of such a cardboard box. I have put it outlined, wrapped up in wallpaper, and I have stuck a regular double-sided sticky tape onto one of the workpieces. This way, I was cutting it. It is even easier with a rectangular bottom than with a round one, but we can use it as well for making a round bottom by cutting and sticking the tape by pieces. Here you see we have a workpiece already. Now I unstuck the upper layer of the tape. There is only the lower layer left. And I stick, or at least pull the tubes onto this tape. Why I like this method is because it doesn't take much time, and now we can turn it the way we like it. Before I learned this method, my tubes were falling apart, I had to collect them, I didn't know from which side to start, but now the work goes much faster and I can make 3-4 bottoms during one evening. Now the whole construction is ready. Look, it is very convenient, nothing is falling. Now I just drop some PVA glue. I even have no necessity to use any other kind of glue. I drop some of it a little further from the edge. I press it with the second workpiece and leave it under the press overnight. It is what we've got overnight.
То есть оно полностью все приклеилось. И теперь переходим вот к тому, о чем я говорила.
It has all gotten stuck.
Изначально.
And now we pass on to what I was talking about at the beginning. How to avoid holes at the joints.
Один ряд проплетаем.
Before lifting the poles, we twine the tubes round in the regular way of rope in horizontal position. This way we weave the whole circle. We have twined the bottom round. Now turn the bottom to continue weaving in the same direction and leave the tubes passing two at a time. Lately I've always done this way and we get a more expressive edge. Pass two tubes, lift. Pass two tubes and lift. The sense of this piece of advice is that we get an additional quarter of inch gap from each side. The form fits in looser.
Трубочки уже вплотную, но тем не менее зазоров возле дна не останется.
And we will weave pressing the tubes close to the form, but there will be no gaps remained.
Так мы получили картонное дно в обрамлении, специально сделала контрастные трубочки, чтобы и четче видно было.
So we've got the cardboard bottom in framing. I've taken the tubes of the contrast color on purpose to make it more visible.
И теперь плетем, прижимая.
Put the form onto its place. Put it right onto the bottom.
Вытащить нам форму теперь уже.
And now we've pressing the tubes to the walls. It will be easier to drag the form out, and at the same time it hugs the form rather tightly, and the wicker work becomes neater. So, I don't think I've opened any secret for experienced weavers, but for the beginners, this piece of advice can be useful. I wish you success.